On today's video, we're going to cock a crossbow with a cocking rope, and then we're going to load it up. Hey there, outdoor YouTubers. It's Dave Kinetter from Kinetter's Practical Outdoors. And like I said earlier, today I'm going to show you guys how to cock a crossbow with a cocking rope. This is a pretty simple, cheap way to cock a crossbow, and then we're going to safely load the crossbow. Okay guys, what you want to do is point the crossbow down, put your foot into the stirrup, and then make sure you've got good hands-free control over the crossbow. Take your cocking rope and pull these pulley hooks all the way out to the outside edges. Find the cocking rope lip on your crossbow. It's generally going to be in this vicinity. Put the center of the cocking rope right on that cocking rope lip. Reach down, put the hook pulleys right on the bowstring. Make sure they're nice and tight to the side of the rail. Take a handle in each hand and pull up firmly until you hear the bowstring engage into the trigger mechanism. Then, to get the cocking rope out of the bowstring, kind of lift and always kind of use gravity. Don't reach down in and around this triangle area of the crossbow itself in case this was to accidentally fire. Now, this crossbow automatically goes to safety when it's been cocked, but if yours doesn't, immediately put it on safety. Okay guys, all we want to do here, we want to make sure our crossbow is on safety. Okay, we want to take the bolt, grab it near the front end. Okay, find the off-colored fletching. That's the fletching that's going to point straight down into the shooting rail, and then just slowly slide it back until the nock engages with the string. As you can see, I didn't put my hand anywhere back here at all. If this crossbow were to accidentally fire, I don't want my fingers in harm's way of the string coming forward. Okay, that's why I grab it up here. And I also don't want to grab it in front of the bolt and load it, because if it was to accidentally fire, I don't want that bolt shooting through my hand either. So you always just want to grab it near the front of the bolt. Again, find the off-colored fletching. That's the fletching that points straight down into the channel that's on your shooting rail, and just gently push it back until the nock engages with the string. And now your crossbow is loaded. Another thing to be aware of, if you are loading your crossbow with a bolt that has a broadhead on it, make sure you don't accidentally nick or cut your bowstring with that broadhead. And of course, you don't want to nick or accidentally cut your hand with that broadhead either. Another safety tip, guys, after you cock your crossbow, you might be tempted to take this cocking rope and just put it around your neck. Okay, especially if you're target practicing, you might want to keep it around your neck. It's nice and handy for the next time that you cock your crossbow. All right, but what can happen when you go to shoot your crossbow? Sometimes this cocking rope can find its way in and around the bowstring, okay? And then when you fire it, if it's snagged in that bowstring, it'll grab it and it'll pull it off from around your neck, okay? You don't want that to happen, all right? So, never keep your cocking rope around your neck when you're shooting your crossbow. You know, guys, most of these cocking ropes come with quite a bit of length to them, but they are adjustable. As you can see, I took a few inches of length out of this one. And what you want to do is you want to adjust the length to match your crossbow, all right? When you're pulling up on it, you only want to have to pull up so far. You don't want to have to be pulling up past your ears to cock your crossbow. So, like I say, adjust the length to match the crossbow that you have. Okay guys, and just another reminder, you know, always treat a crossbow just like you would a gun. Always consider it to be loaded, always consider it to be able to fire off at any time, so always keep it pointed in a safe direction. Don't point it at anything that you're not willing to shoot. Okay guys? All right. Well, hey, also, remember to hunt, fish, laugh, repeat. This is Dave Knetter from Knetter's Practical Outdoors. Hey, thanks for watching and God bless.